Allahu Barakatuhu. Welcome back children for the class 9 standard. Today we are going to study the topic in sociology about family. Yeah, you have heard about this family, right? You have been studied in your early classes also. A family consists of members, family members. Either it's a small family or big family. So we are going to highlight, we are going to study about the family. What are the features? Who are the members, importance, everything, right? So here, before we go to the topic, let us have a small introductory on family. When man formed many social institutions to fulfill his basic need, among that institution, family is the most important, right? Without family, we cannot survive our life here. So all the activities of the society are conducted on the basis of family, right? It is a main important to society. So the word family is derived from a Latin word called famulus, means to serve. Famulus means to serve. Family includes marriage, kinship or adoption. So here, before going here to this kinship, in the sense here, blood relation. The what is family here? Family means the living together of husband and wife with children or without children for a long time is considered as family. Okay? Now, when we have been learning the meaning and our mindset to the social institutions, now let us move on what all the family contains here. The family directs, you are living in a family. Family directs the social behavior, dressing, rituals and other issues of its members. Okay children? Now, let us move on to the characteristics of family. So, we have total 6 features of the family. Number 1, family is universal. Number 2, it is a basic unit of all social activities. Number 3, continuous responsibility and social accountability. Number 4, bringing up and nurturing. Number 5, teaches social behavior. Number 6, it instructs the tradition. Okay? Now let's move on to the first characteristics of family. Family is universal. How? Family is found in all society. Yes, we have been seeing it. We have been living in a society, to your neighbors and everywhere we see the family. So it is being called, it is considered as found in all the societies. Family follows some fixed patterns, issues. What are those like? Marriage. Then second comes here for nurturing, kinship and property rights here. We have all this. So yeah, the issue that they are fixed. We have some fixed pattern in issues of family like marriages, nurturing, kinship and property rights here. So generally the members which they belong to only to that particular family. Can that outsider has? No, only a person living in a family, it resembles to them. Next, second one. The second it is being called as, the second characteristics, it is the basic unit of all social activities. So what it considers here, the basic unit of a family, the activities which we have been dealing in a family here, right? What are those here? It deals with political, economical, educational and several other activities that begins in society. So here it's a right for us, any local committee we take part in this. Right. So here, the increased complexity of social life, the functions of the family have been arranged on social institutions. Different family, they follow the different way of life. Next thought comes here, continuous responsibility and social accountability. In this, the family teaches the members how to behave. Yeah. So we have been brought up by parents, they teach us difference between the good and bad. We have been brought up. If we go in a wrong way, they are the one to correct us. So they teach us a good behavior, how to discharge the specific responsibility. They give us some responsibility that we have to here. Can we go against that? No. So the next comes here, bringing up and nurturing. Bringing up and nurturing, it creates a basic right and responsibility that gives to children. So it protects, yes, nurturing in the sense of care for encouragement. Our parents care. Your parents will care so much for you to bringing up, hey, my child should not go in any wrong way. If a child goes in wrong way, they try to correct in a very good way, right? Next comes teachers' social behavior. Do we learn it from outside the family? We learn it everything from family. So this teaches your teacher's social behavior, childhood and adolescence are very important stages in the process of socialization. We have been brought up from childhood. Our mother is the first teacher and mother tongue. We learn the first as a language of our mother tongue is the first language. Our mother tongue in a family, we try to learn it. And mother is the first teacher and home is the first school for us. So the family teaches behavior like friendship, freedom, security during childhood, adolescence and adulthood and also old age. Next, it instructs the tradition. What is this one? Several generations introduces the kinship, continuation from one generation to other generation, blood relationship here. So here, your grandparents will be the first generation and your parents will be the second and third generation, the children here. So the tradition get continuous from one generation to another generation. The family of father, mother and children is called second generation. Next, family that includes grandparents, parents, children is called third generation. I think you have been living it with grandparents, right? That means you are in third generation. A family that has grandparents, your grandparents, parents, children, grandchildren, that is called extended family. Right. I hope you have been followed till here, children. Let us move to the next class, the continuation.